A stunning revelation today from Defense Secretary Jim Mattis about Russia's determination to influence U.S. elections and how it is still happening, he says. Here's what he said about Vladimir Putin during an event in California earlier today.
There is no doubt the relationship has worsened. He tried again to muck around in our elections this last month, and we are seeing a continued effort along those lines.
These comments from Mattis come one day after White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders used the words Russian witch hunt hoax when referring to the Mueller investigation into Russia's 2016 election meddling. And we've learned President Trump and Putin spoke informally at the G20 summit in Argentina, even though Trump canceled their formal talks, citing Russia's standoff with Ukraine. Putin telling reporters a short time ago he and Trump discussed events in Ukraine during their informal meeting. CNN senior White House correspondent Jeff Zeleny joins us now from Buenos Aires. Jeff, what more are you hearing?
Anna, good evening. We do know that all the talk of election meddling was done by Defense Secretary James Mattis. That was not a conversation that was had here, at least publicly, at the G20 summit by the president or others. The White House has very much wanted to move beyond that at every one of these world gatherings that they have. But we do know, as you said, that the president was meeting on the sidelines with the Russian President Vladimir Putin. It came at a dinner last evening when all of the world leaders were there. There was no sense of if that was an extensive conversation or not. It appears to be a very brief conversation. So certainly, I would say a lost opportunity at this world summit here, the G20 summit, by not again having a chance for the two leaders to speak face to face. But we did hear from Vladimir Putin before he left town. He said this about President Trump.
Of course, we were there. We were talking to each other. I had a talk with President Trump, however brief, and I answered his questions about the incident in the Black Sea. He has his position on that, and I have mine. But we didn't change those positions, but I informed him about how we view that incident. I think it's a pity that we didn't succeed in having a full-fledged meeting because I think the time is ripe.
So Vladimir Putin saying right there, speaking to reporters, that he has a difference of opinion, a disagreement with the U.S. president. But Donald Trump was scheduled to have a press conference here this afternoon in Buenos Aires. He canceled that press conference out of respect, he said, for President George H.W. Bush. But there is a sense that President Trump clearly also not wanting to be faced with other questions here about the Russia investigation and other matters. But President Trump right now on his way to the airport and with no meeting under his belt again with Vladimir Putin. Anna.
But he did have a 2.5-hour dinner with China's president, which just ended prior to his trip to the airport. Do you know anything more than that it was long?
He did, Anna, and you can see those pictures there from the very beginning of the meeting. That was the only time we saw the leaders. There were eight or so representatives of each side meeting, and this was the most consequential meeting of this entire G20 summit. The escalation of the this ongoing trade war between the U.S. and China. Certainly, there are hopes that there might be some type of a resolution, but at this hour, we do not know if there was a resolution of any kind at that dinner. The presidents, the leaders there, as you can see, sitting across from each other. At one point, it seemed like the dinner was only going to be an hour or so, but then it lasted a bit longer, so about 2.5 hours altogether. So we are still waiting to find out if there was a resolution, if there will be a freeze, if you will, in this ongoing escalation and a trade war. But the president right now heading to the airport as we speak, flying back to Washington tonight.